You know, grassroots support in New Hampshire, 164 towns passed a resolution calling for national leadership on the issue. How do you see the federal government's role in that problem, and what would you do as president?
Well, the first thing I'd urge is make sure everybody reads both sides of that argument, because there's a lot of science on both sides of that argument, a lot of history that questions both sides. And then, again, the only time the federal government would be involved, once again, I would defer to the states. If you have a polluted city here, you got to clean it up, and it's up to you to do it. But if it involves state boundaries and air coming across the river and state boundary, or internationally, so to speak, you try to cut down on pollution. But there's some pretty strong evidence that show that global warming, which comes and goes, is not explained only by CO2. And I claim that I do not know the answer, but I claim that is something that everybody should study.
So if the states, you know, I think there's a lot of action on the state level right now, how would you ensure that it would happen on a global scale?
Well, it wouldn't be through the legislative process. It would be through, states getting together. Matter of fact, sometimes two states can get together by themselves and work out a deal better than the federal government. But if there is a conflict between states, then the federal government has the authority to do it. To come up with one solution and say, we know the absolute truth about every one of these things and we're going to take care of it, it's not going to work. I think it'll make more problems for us. If we try to do it within the confines of, you know, if the Constitution helps us out in other things, we get a little nervous about one thing, you just can't reject what you'll be like the rest. You reject the whole thing. So you try your very best, and sometimes you have to change the Constitution. And, you know, if there's no full knowledge about the environmental things, I don't think you need to. I mean, state individuals don't have a right to pollute, cities don't have a right to pollute, governments don't have a right to pollute, and if one state's doing it, there's every reason in the world for some states to get together and solve the problem. But if there's a pollution problem between Canada and the United States, they have every reason to sit down and talk about it.